It's Nutrition Q&A with Pat Cassady, brought to you by ADM Alliance Nutrition. Hi, I'm Rick Lamb. Pat, today's question is, what do I need to know about ulcers?
Probably they've always had ulcer problems, but our awareness of it is much bigger today because we can scope horses now and see inside their stomach. Indicators of ulcers are odd behavior before or after a meal. I've seen horses that would take their foot and pound the ground or roll or mild colic. You know, if you see a horse that acts like what he's going to eat is going to hurt him and he's going to be uncomfortable, that's a sign that maybe you have an ulcer. The other factor, I think, is how far out of his natural environment have we got him? Places like the racetrack are kind of a high anxiety place. To add to the problem, they feed large amounts of cereal grain at the racetrack. Cereal grains are acidic. When you feed large amounts of them, you're going to possibly burn that stomach, cause an ulcer. Now, most of the time, we recommend that you make diet changes gradually. If you suspect or determine that that horse was having a problem with a cereal grain diet and was having ulcers, I would stop the cereal grain immediately because there's no point in aggravating that further. I might start him on the next diet gradually, but I'm at least going to take that away pretty immediately because I don't want to just further the problem. There's medications. Imeprazine is the common drug in there, like Prilosec for humans. Do a good job. Usually have to feed them for a couple weeks. Pretty pricey. So if you can, don't cause ulcers in the first place by making the environment as natural as you can for this animal. He's a grazing animal. He needs to be social. He needs to be out if he can. You can pretty much stay away from ulcers and not have the problem.
To learn more about ADM Alliance Nutrition, visit growstrong.com. That's GROstrong.com.